So in the previous section, Phillip explained why the problem of multiple pattern matching is important. And he further gave an algorithm for solving the multiple patterns matching problem. But let's see, what is the way that he solved the problem? Here is the genome as a road, and here's the pattern as a student. So basically what Phillip does is he asks the student to go along the road and find all the matches that the pattern can match. But please remember that we have multiple patterns. So this approach forces us to slide the patterns along the genome multiple times. Okay? Here we slide. This approach takes a lot of time. The time complexity of this algorithm is big O of the genome size multiple by the combined length of patterns. In practice, the combined length of all the patterns is huge, and this algorithm is not that practical. Now, I'm describing another approach. So instead of asking individual patterns to go along the genome one at a time, I now pack all the patterns into a single structure and move this structure along the genome only once. So it is similar to packing all the student onto a bus and move the bus just once on the road. This data structure has a very important property. It can retrieve the pattern very quickly. Like if a father here asks if Taka is on this bus, the bus driver can say, I can retrieve Taka very quickly. So this data structure is called a Trie, coming from the word retrieval. So the Trie is a data structure for representing a collection of patterns. And the Tries support fast pattern matching. Now, given us a set of patterns, the idea is to combine all these patterns into a rooted tree with branches labeled by letters in the alphabet. And every string in the patterns corresponds to a path from root to leaf. Let's go through this example with me to understand how we can construct a Trie from a collection of patterns. Okay. We start with a root, and the first pattern is banana. So from the root, the first character of banana is B. There's no B here, so we have to create a new branch and label it by B. The next character is A. So we have to create a new branch and label it by A, and so on, so forth, and A. So for the next pattern, P-A-N, we start from the root. There's no P, so we have to create a new branch P here, okay? And A, and the next one is AND. We start from the root. There's no AND going down from the root, so we have to create one. A, and the next one is AND. Next one is NAP, NAP. We start from the root. We don't have N, so we have to create a new one, NAB, okay? Antenna. We start from the root, but please note that A here, we have a branch labeled by A, so we don't have to create a new one. We just follow it down, go to next N. Here, the next one is T. We don't have T, so we have to create a new one. And E, N, and A. The next one is bandana. We start from the root. We have B already, so we don't have to create a new one. So A, N. There's no D going down, so we have to create a new one. And A. Okay. Next one is ananas. We have A already, so we just follow down. And here, A, we don't have A. We have to create a new A. Okay, and A, S. The next one is nana. We start from the root. A, sorry, nana, we go through A, N, A. There's no N next, so we have to create a new one here. A, okay? So this tree, this rootic tree, is called a trie, constructed from the set of patterns. So a trie is a rootic tree with branches labeled by letters in the alphabet. Every pattern is a path from the root to a leaf. For example, banana it corresponds to a path from the root to the leaf. But please note that in this example, we have some errors here. If you want to construct a trie for yourself, you need to add a new character's dollar at the end of each pattern. We don't have space, so allow us to have some mistake here. So the question now is how to use the trie for pattern matching. Before, Phillip has to move individual pattern one at a time along the genome to find the match. Now, we have already created a special structure called a trie that pack all the patterns into a single data structure. Now, the only thing we have to do is to move this data structure along the genome. Okay? Let's take as an example. Here, we have the string as the genome, pandama, bananas. This is the trie constructed from the set of patterns we want to match. First, we put the trie at the first position of the string, P. And we want to ask a question, whether there is any pattern in this connection that can match at this position on the genome. So we just walk down from the root. Here is P. So there's a 1P match. We walk down A, N. So good. So at this position, we can find a match, pen. We move the trie to the next position. So, and we try to walk down the tree from the root to the leaf of the tree to find if there's any match. So we can find A here. Next one is N. Next one is A. Yes, we can find. Next one is M. No, in the tree, we don't have anything going out from this, but have label M. So at this position, we cannot find any match. We move the trie one more time. And here, A, M. We cannot find M. So there is no match at this position. We move to the next. We start with A. And here we got stuck, we cannot match, so we have to move. We can say that at this position, there is no pattern that match. This position, immediately, there's no match. Next position, A here, there's no match here. We move to the next, B, A, N, A, N, A, S. OK, so we can find a match here. So we move it to the next one, A, N, A, N, A, S. Exactly. So we can find a match at this position. So next one is N, A, N, A. We can find a match. So we move next. A, N, A, S. There's no S walking down. So at this position, we cannot find any pattern that match. Similarly, we move the trie. Here we cannot find any match. Here we cannot find a match. Here, immediately, we cannot find match. OK? So to recap, in this section, I have described a data structure called the trie, which is a representation of a collection of strings. This data structure allows us to retrieve a pattern from the collections very quickly. And the runtime of the trie matching, now we have reduced it to the genome multiplied by the longest pattern, where in the previous algorithm that Phillip described, it takes genome multiplied by the total length of all the particles.